Welcome to the second video in this series on StorSimple 8000 migration to Azure File Shares and Azure File Sync. My name is Terry Clancy. In this video, Phase 1, Prepare for Migration, we discuss the steps we recommend to prepare for migration off StorSimple to Azure File Shares. This includes selection of storage options, selecting whether to use direct access to Azure File Shares or Azure File Sync, selecting which backups to migrate, the mapping of StorSimple shares to Azure File Shares, and the collection of data needed during the migration. In the first video in this series, we step through the recommended process for migration from StorSimple to Azure File Shares and Azure File Sync, as overviewed on this slide. So, in this video, I will discuss the recommended steps for planning and preparation before you start this process. In later videos, we will talk in more detail about each of the steps in this migration process. Azure File Shares open up a whole new world of opportunities for structuring your file services deployments. An Azure File Share is just an SMB share in the cloud that you can set up to have users access directly over the SMB protocol using the familiar Kerberos authentication and existing NTFS access control list or ACL permissions working natively in the cloud. Or, alternatively, you can use Azure File Sync to provide familiar on-prem SMB shares with hot files cached locally and cold files optionally tiered to the cloud. Caching provides faster performance and local SMB shares simplify access and security. So, for each Azure File Share, you need to decide if you want users to access it directly in the cloud or access it on-prem using Azure File Sync. Direct access means you do not need on-premises servers, whereas Azure File Sync simplifies access, increases performance, and keeps a lot of the network traffic local. Note that you can use direct access on some shares, perhaps archive shares that are not used much, and Azure File Sync on other shares, perhaps frequently used shares where performance is more important. But for any particular share, we do not recommend using both Direct Access and Azure File Sync. You should then select your destination storage tiers. If you're using Azure File Sync, then most of the transaction load is front-ended by the Windows server running the AFS agent. So the cool tier of storage is most likely to be the lowest priced and best choice. For most general purpose users connecting directly to Azure File Shares, that is not through Azure File Sync, your tier selection will depend on data size, transactional load, and performance requirements. Use the Azure Pricing Calculator for comparisons. You will also need to select your desired level of storage redundancy. We recommend the use of large file shares which can grow to 100 terabytes and also have better performance. At this time, this is only supported by LRS and ZRS, so we suggest you choose one of those. We plan to support 100 terabyte GRS shares at a later time. Your StorSimple service data encryption key is also important, and you should already have it recorded for each of your StorSimple devices. It is needed to fail over to a new device if your device fails. It is also needed to migrate off StorSimple. If you do not have it recorded now and stored in a safe place for each StorSimple device, please do so now using the instructions provided at the link on this page. Please also ensure you have the serial number recorded for each device. We will need it to assist you with your migration, so please include the serial numbers in any communications with us. StorSimple device serial numbers are simple to access and the instructions are provided on this slide. StorSimple offers differential backups on the volume level. StorSimple Data Manager migration jobs use the latest StorSimple volume backup as the source. So at a minimum, ensure that all your volumes have a very recent backup, which can be used as a source for the migration. These backups can take a while, so do this sometime before you want to start a migration. Before starting your migration, you need to decide if, as part of the migration, you also have a need to move any of those StorSimple snapshot backups into your new Azure File Shares. If so, then select the set of backups to migrate that meet your needs. If possible, bring a subset of your backups rather than all of them. When defining your StorSimple Data Manager migration jobs, you will have the opportunity to select the backups you want to migrate. If your backups only need to be retained for a short period, say 2 months, one good option is not to move the backups and keep your StorSimple online for 2 months while you build the required backup history in Azure File Shares. You can then deprovision StorSimple. However, this is not such a good idea if you need to keep backups for a long period, because you would be paying to store 2 copies of much of your data over a long period. Before you start your migration, you need to decide how many Azure File Shares you will need. As part of that, you should define the mapping between your existing shares and the new Azure File Shares. Note that StorSimple shares exist in volumes, whereas Azure File Shares do not require volumes. StorSimple volumes are the level at which snapshot backups are done, which defines a relatively coarse granularity for these functions. Azure File Shares do not exist in volumes, and so backups or snapshots, as well as storage tier selection, are done at the share level. This provides finer granularity of control for snapshots and other functions. StorSimple volumes are also the level at which performance is limited, whereas with Azure File Shares, performance limits are per share. This allows for much greater scope in scaling performance with Azure File Shares. If you are planning to use Azure File Sync, note that each Windows server running the AFS agent can sync a maximum of 30 Azure File Shares. If you want more than 30 on-premises file shares per server, you can group several on-premises shares into one Azure File Share. An Azure Sync Service Sync Group is defined by a cloud endpoint, which is an Azure File Share, and a server endpoint, which is a folder on a Windows Server machine. On the Windows Server machine, you can share out the root of the server endpoint as an on-premises share, as shown on the left here, which gives you one on-premises share per Azure File Share. Or you can share out several descendant folders underneath the server endpoint, as shown on the right here, which allows you to group many on-premises shares into an Azure File Share. As you define your share mapping, there is a number of considerations and best practices to keep in mind. Once again, there is a limit of 30 Azure File Sync groups per on-prem Windows server. Aim for less than 25 to allow for growth. Sync groups are tested up to 100 million items, but aim for not more than 30 million. Azure File Shares have a restriction of 100 terabytes. An Azure Storage account can contain one or more Azure File Shares, but note, a single storage account is capable of about 20,000 IOPS, and a single Azure File Share can drive around 10,000 IOPS. So 2 Azure File Shares driving hard can occupy the capacity of a storage account. Now, this is relevant for hot shares using direct cloud access, but archive shares and Azure File Shares accessed through Azure File Sync, which front-ends most of the load, are unlikely to demand anywhere near 10,000 IOPS, and so several shares per storage account can be used. Before starting your migration, you should also decide on your naming conventions and names for the resources that will be used. This page lists some of the naming restrictions that you will need to comply with. One of the first tasks in preparing to migrate from StorSimple shares to Azure File Shares is to collect and catalog details about your existing StorSimple installation so you have the information you need to take the considerations we have discussed into account, and so make informed decisions about how best to map those StorSimple shares into Azure File Shares. To assist with this process, we recommend you use this macro-enabled spreadsheet to take a complete inventory of your current StorSimple deployment. If you don't want to run the macros, that's okay. You can just copy the table format from the first worksheet and create your own table and fill it out manually. All the macros do is automatically create the table for each of the planning steps below. For example, if you have 2 sites and there is 1 device in the first site and 3 in the second, enter this data, and when you press Next Step, it generates the next step for you. You will then be taken to the next page, where it will have created a table for you with the appropriate number of rows pre-populated, so you can then add device names, model numbers, and number of volumes. Once that information is entered, you would then press Next Step to create the next input table. For this step, you would input volumes. volume name and number of shares per volume. Once your entries are completed, you would press Next Step to generate the next input table. For the next step, you will enter share names as well as the file and folder counts for each share. You can obtain the file and folder counts from several tools. One tool we find effective for this is the tree size tool from Jam Software. Also, enter the level of churn for each share. This helps you make decisions about share mapping. For example, archive shares can have a larger number of files and a lower performance than other shares, but without adverse consequences. Carefully considering this information about file size and data usage will help you with your initial judgment call as to whether you feel each share is a candidate for either splitting or merging with other folders. Enter that conclusion here. Once your inventory is complete, you will have what you need to use the considerations we discussed earlier to define your share mapping and complete the namespace mapping spreadsheet. This defines where your shares will end up once you migrate them to Azure File Shares. When completing this spreadsheet, be sure to comply with the namespace limitations and conventions previously mentioned. With all this done, you are now ready to move on to phase two of the migration. Deploy Azure Storage and Migration Resources. Here are some of the resources you can leverage to help you plan for your StorSimple migration and to learn more about Azure File Shares. And here are some links for Azure File Sync and the StorSimple Data Manager Migration Tool. Should you have any other StorSimple migration-related questions we could answer, feel free to contact us at storsimp@microsoft.com. That is storsimp@microsoft.com. If you complete the migration process without our assistance, we ask that you please email us to let us know when you have completed your migration. If you do email us, please include your StorSimple serial numbers so we can effectively track your migration status. We hope that this video provides you with the necessary information to plan your StorSimple migration. Thanks for listening, and we wish you the best with your migration.